ಗೋವಿಂದವೃಗಾಯ ಪದಾಬ್ಜರಾಗ ಶ್ರೀಕುಂಕುಮೇನ ದಯಿತಾಸ್ತನ ಮನ್ನಿತೇನ ತದ್ದರ್ಶನ ಸ್ಮರರುಜ ದೃಢರುಷಿತೇನ ಲಿಂಪಂತ್ಯಯಾನನ ಕುಚೇಷು ಜಹುಸ್ತದಾ. My blissful gorgeous sir, my comment is very simple. Just like in Mahabharata, in the forest, when Arjuna was totally exhausted wrestling with Bhagavan Shiva, who came to him challenging his power in the form of a Pulinda youth, Kirata youth, then he mentally worshipped Bhagavan Shiva and offered him the lotus garland, and when he opened his eyes he saw all items of his worship including lotus garland was on the form of this Pulinda youth, this Kirata youth. He recognized immediately in this case all over the world wherever Bhagavan Sri Krishna is worshipped mentally, is physically, and embraced on the Sri Kumkum pasted breasts of female devotees, it all goes to the lotus feet of Sri Krishna every day, every morning, because the Brahma Muhurta, the Brahma Muhurta or dawn is the time when all these are offered, and every morning his feet are reddish. It goes on reddening, reddening, reddening his feet all along till 9:30 a.m. By the late worshippers, it is an ongoing process, and all household ladies are mostly are late worshippers because of the household duties they have to complete early morning. So they are late worshippers. So the Sri Kumkum came from not only gopis but from worshippers throughout the world, and that got smeared on the grass of Vrindavan. Hey, Sri Krishna was there. When Pulinda girls are over flooded with loving emotions and unite with Sri Krishna, they carefully pick up these Sri Kumkum from the grass and shrubs of Vrindavan and smear them on their faces and breasts. Thus they calm their fire of separation, longing for union. ಲಿಂಪಂತ್ಯಯಾನನ ಕುಚೇ ಶುಜಹುಸ್ತದಾಧಿಂ. ನಾವು ಸುಖದೇವ್ಜಿ ಮಹಾರಾಜ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಗಿರಿರಾಜ್ ಗೋವರ್ಧನ್. ಹಂತಾಯ ಮದ್ರಿರಮಲಾಹರಿದಾಸವರ್ಯೋ ಯಂ ರಾಮಕೃಷ್ಣ ಚರಣ ಸ್ಪರ್ಶ ಪ್ರಬೋದ ಮಾನತನೋತಿ ಸಗೋ ಗಣಯೋಸ್ತಯೋರ್ಯ ಪಾನೀಯ ಸೂಯವ ಸಕಂದರ ಕಂದ ಮೂಲೈ. ಓ ಡಿಯರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಗೋಪಿ ಸೇಡ್, ಲುಕ್ ಇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗಿರಿ ಗೋವರ್ಧನ್, ಹಿ ಸರ್ವ್ಸ್ our beloved Krishna so greatly. Ati iti adrihi, and Krishna served him by big eating during the festival of Annakoot, bucket full of kheer and rabri and basket full of puris and kachoris and thousands of sweet balls. That is how he eats. Same way he worships opulently. There are 5 items of worship, 10 items of worship, 15 item worship and 18 item worship and 60 item worship and 64 item worships. Then there are Rajopachar and Maharajopachar worships. Giriraj does all and much more. Not only he worships our beloved Krishna, but also Sahagoganayostayorya to all the holy cows and gopas walking with them. He worships all of them. Manam tanoti, not a dry lip service, not empty honor, but also offers nectarine water, green grass, coral caves for shelter in rain, kunja and nikunja powers to hide and play. He feasts them with kanda to fry and eat, and mool to eat raw. He is so thrilled, swelled, and fattened by the enthralling touch of the lotus feet of Sri Krishna, looking like made of rocks, clay, and trees, but a very fragile heart is shining luminous inside these forms. Oh, Giriraj, you are the best of Haridasas. You are great indeed. Alas, we cannot do anything which even our Giriraj can do. Ga gopakairanuvana nayato rudara venuswanai kalapadai tanubhitsu sakya aspandanam gadimata and Kali Beach as well, my dear friends. Fountain source of material pleasures and divine love and power. Krishna emanates this powerful sound through his flute music, Venuswanai. It is not only sound, but also song. Sushirvati, all ragas and raganis filled in his heart, and now he is letting them all out. Aspandanam, aspandanam gatimatam pulakastarunam. Surrounded by holy cows and little cow boys, Krishna is moving from one forest to another, to another, to another. He is also playing his entrancing flute. At that time he has wrapped Niryoga string around his turban and posh string on his shoulders. He enhanced his beauty so much that entire nature means this string placing on his shoulders has enhanced his beauty so much that entire nature is thrilled. Vines and trees begin to smile in blooming flowers. Rocks and stones begin to melt, and river Yamuna stopped flowing. All locomotion stilled and stopped and entranced in the divine bliss, my dear friends. Evam vidha bhagavato ya vrindavana charina varnayantyo mito gopya kridas tanmayatam yayo. Sri Shukdev ji Maharaj says, dear King Parikshit, recounting to one another transcendental pastimes of Bhagavan Sri Krishna of Vrindavan, who always moves about in his sacred woods, the gopi's inner self became deeply absorbed in Prem Samadhi in the visions of Sri Krishna and enthralled, absorbed, intoxicated with his experience, they began to sing Are Kare Badara, Are Kare Badara, Tome Shyam Hirade Re, Manda Manda Murale Duri Gajat, Gajat, Gajat Madan Nisane. The fame of flute-playing Krishna is spreading in all directions, even to this day, millions of years later in the world of love yogis and yoginis. Just like it will continue, just like in the lakes, growing catkins explode their white cotton seeds all around, like pure heart of love-intoxicated one, the fully washed clean earth and crystal sky overhead appeared vast and cosmic. Sky is looking like wearing the dress of an ascetic with thin white clouds instead of dark clouds of rainy season, like beautiful cheerful faces of newly wedded housewife in the joint family of India. The long ducks and swans are quaking near the river. As the dusk descends, moon shines as ever rubbed on a polishing stone and gotten brilliant effulgence. As if ointments smeared on the person of an Ottoman lady, the stars are twinkling in the sky. Transparent waters reflecting the moon as the wisdom of the Vedic culture instantly shines forth in the mind of an unconfused, clean-hearted person. Wind is teaching the lotuses of ponds and rivers to dance, rock and roll back and forth with her scented, gentle, aromatic frieze. Ottoman lady dressed and ornamented herself as bride, now enchanting and pleasing the mind of Sri Krishna. Oh, look, friends, Krishna tells his friend at times, fingering up at the flocks of geese flying and quaking overhead. Big perfumey kadamba flowers have blossomed and cranes pick them and make big garland and decorate Sri Krishna with them. Nachat murani sanga sham shama hirjavat kokila jalapat papihara gavat megha mridang बजावत रिझिरावे अति कंठ लगावत. Krishna is laughing, looking so elegant with his crest of fresh iridescent peacock feathers. When he finds dancing peacocks and peons considering him to aid one of them, then he cheers up his friends. He also starts dancing like them. When competition begins and Krishna wins, this dance is still enacted in Vrindavan during the month of Shravan Surat Punam. Puraniyoshame. Oh no, look at the peacock feather ascended. Beautiful locks of Krishna's curly dark hair, curly car, Amalta's flowers, hung hung over his ears, dangling exquisitely at his cheeks, wrapped in an effulgent golden pitambara and vajanti garland, hanging from his neck, dressed as the best of dancers Krishna play with his friends in Vrindavan all day long. Now he felt the tinge of torment to meet his beloved doe-eyed gopis who have shot him with the arrows of their sidelong glances. While walking along the path, Sri Krishna leaves his footprints of lotus and conchen gold and others. Holding his flute to his leaf-like lips, he plays Malo Rag. Sri Rag, his fingers dance deftly over its holes. Great floods of nectar spread out in the space. Variety of tunes began to emanate and flow. Streams of ragini and ragas began to ooze from his dazzling, smiling face. These melodies, entwined with the marvelous sweet pastime, thrilled and spaced down all living beings of Vrindavan. All over the world, all over the Brahmanda. River and pond and ditches and fountain water are freeing to solid gems. The gems and jewels are popping out. Hard rocks of mountains are melting into rivers and rivers of ecstasy, and dead trees springing to life with fresh green leaves. It went to the silent caves of Himalayas and maddened the entranced yogis into bliss of a new kind of Krishna love. Birds and animals got transfixed on gorgeous, splendid, smiling face of Krishna. With great yearning, longing and torment, the gopis gathered in mango grove and looked into the direction of the flute sound coming. They wished to run down, where Sri Krishna is standing. But to their utter surprise, Krishna appeared right there, wearing on his forehead the peacock feather crown, radiant sandal pasted lotus face, with thick glossy locks of his dark blue hair swirling, thick garland upon his knees, up to his knees, bouquet of fresh flowers and twigs and leaves, mineral powder gracing, decorating his each of limbs. Oh, like drama actors walking on the stage, Krishna arrived there. The gopis saw his blinking him through their eyes, their throat choked up with great love, and tossed by insurmountable waves of longing to embrace Krishna, the gopis opened their heart. Bhijan lagere do jan achara ki ot karat do jan prema sindh vrindave bina